The important part is that I was on my way home, and I was in the car with my brothers, and I'm like, guys, I have to tell you something, and at this point I'm like trembling, it's like, but I said to them, I'm like, guys, I'm gay, and my brother Zach says, get out of the car, as a joke, of course, it is like this, you know, like who cares, it really doesn't matter.
I don't have any kind of spiel, but I will speak from my heart, as I always do. I am the president of the Gay Staight Alliance. I'm Rachel Buckner. And our club, I would say, just like all the clubs, is very important, and one of the most important, because we want to make a change in our school, and we want to make a change in society, and further beyond, you know? We want to create equality. We want to make sure every student is protected, every student is treated fairly. As you travel around the school, you'll see that people are not treated with respect, and we aim to change that.
I started the GSA mainly because of my experiences in middle school. You know, I got into a real depression when I was in middle school. I didn't feel like I could talk to anyone. I didn't feel like I belonged. And my perspective in life is that if I'm going through it, there must be someone else who has similar feelings. And one of the main reasons I started the GSA was so that students who have these same feelings can come and share them and not have to feel like they're being subjected to homophobia, you know?
Well, I've known Rachel for a long time now. We've been good family friends, our families and brothers and relatives have always been fairly close, and I've watched her grow up as a great tennis player and a great human being.
Stay intense, but yet have fun. And Tara was right yesterday when she said it's not all about winning, but it is all about putting forth your best effort. And I know that some of you guys do that, and I think most of you on a really tough match do. Just keep that in mind to keep the intensity up. Keep the energy high, all right? I think we can win this. I think we can win the whole league, honestly.
And so when I look at like my being a leader, I don't think I'm a gay leader. I think I'm a universal leader in that I try and help people on the tennis team. I try and, if they lose, I try and get them through that. I try and get them to figure out, why did I lose? What does it mean to lose? Can I grow from that? Can I grow from this experience that seems like it sucks, but really it can be celebrated and learned from?
And now that I see her like taking this leadership, I see for my own team, and I realize that it's not just for me. Like I look from in my season, I look to try to get as far as I can, but I don't see it as that now. I see it more as how could I get my team to do farther in the season, not how far can I get, and how can I take a leadership like my sister did. So.
GSA, Gay Straight Alliance meeting in Mr. Perlman's room on Monday. If you guys can come, I would really appreciate that. We're just going to be going over the introductions of what the club, what the program's all about.
Everybody's going to love today, going to love today, any way you want to, any way you've got to.
Incredible to see every single spot filled in here. I don't think we've ever had that. And I know not every week might be, you know, but might be the situation, but to have all of you guys here right now, it's really incredible to see. And plus, let me just make a shout out to my tennis team, who it's their first time here. They're virgins at this, so let's welcome them. But anyway, no, I'm happy that all of you are here, especially the new people. This is really an important club. Another reason I started the GSA, and sometimes it's not something I really think about, but I'll think back on like a time in ninth grade, and it was when someone shared to me the story of Matthew Shepard and how he was killed. A college student who was going out to a gay bar, and he was tricked and beaten because he supposedly flirted with a guy, and he was killed, and you know, and it's this nice person, you know, genuinely a nice person who's being killed for who they are.
And that was another reason I started the GSA, was just because I couldn't stand not being able to give these people, these fellow peers, a resource, you know, and a place to feel safe and welcome and supported.
So basically, I wrote it up there. There were two 13-year-olds, there was one 15-year-old, and there was an 18-year-old and a 19-year-old. The 18-year-old, as you guys probably heard, is Tyler Clemente, who was a Rutgers student. And basically, he was filmed having sex with a man one time, and then the other one was, I think, just making out with a guy. But his roommate gave him the, you know, right to use the room, and he was like, okay, sure, yeah, you could use the room. And he filmed him and put it on the internet. And I guess 3 days later, he jumped off the GW. So that's a big story that's been going around.
I think the GSA has affected different people on different levels. Some people go, you know, just for the experience, but I do think that there are a lot of people who go who need that support. I mean, I've talked to people who were thinking of, you know, committing suicide or who had problems with sexuality and have gone to the GSA and have told me that they felt welcome, have told me that they feel connected, where before in middle school, maybe they didn't have that resource. Now they come here and they're like, wow, these are people I didn't even know existed. I didn't even know this type of community could take place, especially at Head Hot, you know?
There are so many people in this school who have just been scared and been struggling, whether it's about finding who they are or just anything in general. High school is the hardest years of your life, you know? You're finding out who you are, and she's definitely made people feel more comfortable with themselves. And she doesn't let people struggle alone, and she teaches them how to struggle and how to grow from all their problems and not be ashamed of themselves.
I don't know if I would have been able to get to this point in my life where I'm a leader in several ways if I hadn't gone through my struggles in eighth grade. Now, whether it's because of the sexuality that I was able to do that. Maybe I have to be a gay person maybe I had to go through that struggle of that specific sexual struggle to like get to this point. I don't know. Like maybe it could have been another struggle, but I do know that I had to go through that struggle. I had to go through that depression in order to be not only an LGBT leader, but a leader on the team, a leader in the community. You know, I do think I needed that struggle.
So basically, it's my first comedy act, and I just got back from a great match of tennis. We're going to States, my partner, Daniel Hartman.
It's the funniest thing in the world. Like, you can't help but laugh every time she laughs. And you can pick it out of the line. Like, you can hear it from 10 miles away, and you're just like, oh, Rachel's laughing.
Downstairs. Left all the way.
A laugh, that's so classic.
That's the best word.
Started saying it to be funny. I don't think at that point we knew anyone that was actually gay, and it really wasn't a big deal back then. So you hear on TV all the time, hear it in songs.
Yeah, I think saying that's so gay, I think it's been basically part of our vernacular for a long time now.
When they hear someone say that's so gay, it's in their conscience. When we have discussions, it's in their conscience to say that's not appropriate, that's not right, you shouldn't say that. I've had many friends who have been, from the beginning, supportive of the LGBT, you know, population and community, but they would say themselves, you know, that's so gay. Being at our club and realizing how it affects gay students or transgender students, I think has given them a reason to stop using those words and has taken it from the GSA setting outside, you know.
I'm so retarded. And I, obviously that's like a different word, but I know that with like, I just like thinking about it consciously and having a coach that like works with kids that have autism has like been a constant reminder to like make me stop, and like I consciously want to stop saying it. So I think that if you just remind people in like a way that's saying like, can you please not do that, not like yell at them, as Christina was saying, like I think a lot of times people don't do it intentionally, like they're not doing it with malice, it's just something that they've developed as a bad habit. So
I think that people that have it ingrained and who have a desire to stop need to, if they say it, they just need to catch themselves. Because the more you catch yourself, the more you have an ability to stop. As I said, my friends would use it like constantly. And the more that they said it and were like, oh my God, I didn't mean to. That's what's starting to get ingrained again. It's starting to reset how you perceive language and how you perceive your thoughts. And eventually, stopping yourself will lead to the stopping of, you know, such thoughts and, you know, vocalizing it.
This year, I've really enjoyed it. And I'm going to miss, like, as I said, every one of you. And one thing I'm especially happy about is that Fiona finally talked to me this year. So it's been quite, you know, a progressive year. As you know.
I think a big problem with just society in general is that we stress the differences. You know, you're a Republican, you're a Democrat, you're a liberal, you're a conservative, you're pro-life, you're pro-choice, you know, whatever. And it's not about that. It's how can we be united? And I think the media draws too much attention on that, you know. Obviously we all have our differences, you know. I think that we have to celebrate our differences, but love what we have in common.
She's really someone who should be looked up to. She's a genuine person. She has a kind heart. She always puts others before herself. And this whole thing that she's done for everyone, the journey that she's been through, is truly amazing and just incredible.
It's not about me being gay. There's more of a complex issue around it, and that's the idea of how can we learn from what we've gone through and change ourselves and learn from it and move on. I guess I just want to reiterate that it's not about me being gay, and it's not about me going through a struggle and it ending. I think that I constantly struggle, but through that struggle, I want to help others and I want to help myself. And